always argue about the same thing. Hey, tell me why we gotta argue about the same thing, well.
Nobody's perfect, nobody's perfect, hey, but you're perfect for me. Nobody's perfect, nobody's perfect, hey, but you're perfect for me.
Not the same, say I changed, but I can't leave the game. Now I'm right back to my old ways. I take life so slow, every minute gotta go. Now I'm right back to my old ways. We only here for a little, so I'm somewhere in the middle, and I'm right back to my old ways. I'm not the same, say I changed.
The state of mind of your average porn filmmaker or producer was not an artistic one. And, but over the years, because, you know, it was a male-dominated field, it sort of, there was this perception that this is what men want to see. One of the first things that I was surprised by when I began making porn and talking to fans was how many male fans were coming to me and saying, like, you know, I don't like the way that people never show any emotion in porn. I don't like the fact that there's, you don't see the guy's face. You don't, the woman is treated in this very degrading way. I like to see a little storyline. I like to see, you know, I was hearing all these things from men that really, you know, flew in the face of this belief that men wanted to see nothing but, you know, blow bangs, and they wanted it, you know, all the shocking, degrading kind of stuff. And so I learned pretty early on that, you know, men, just as women, they have a large spectrum of fantasies. There are some guys that they just want to watch two girls making out in their underwear, and they don't even want to see any hardcore sex. That's what they want to see. Lovey-dovey, you know, beautiful girls just making out. And that's, to them, that's porn. That's what they get off on. I know women that watch nothing but the hardest core bukkake scenes. They love kink.com and they look for the most extreme stuff that they can find. People have sexual fantasies for different reasons. We don't always understand why we fantasize about the things that we fantasize about. Sometimes we're surprised by it. Why do I like that? You know, sometimes we want to watch something that we don't want to do in our real lives. We would never want to do it, but we want to watch it. It turns us on to watch it for some reason. So there's a lot we still need to learn about ourselves sexually. And it troubles me that, you know, we've put so much stigma on men and blamed men for something that I really think is a sensibility issue. It's the type of people who were making porn, and it was their agendas. The queer community was very much supported by Good For Her and the Feminist Porn Awards, just showing a different type of sexuality and expression, an artistic expression, and celebrating, you know, women behind the camera that had a different way of presenting sex. And that was obviously, you know, it's a great thing. I never had any kind of a problem with that. I love the Feminist Porn Award people, but when I was constantly referred to as a feminist porn filmmaker, I did take issue with it because I don't think about gender when I'm making a porn movie. I don't think about, well, I want to show this from the woman's perspective. I just think about the fact that I want to show authentic sex, and I want to depict both people as human beings, equal human beings. And one person may have the upper hand in the relationship or in the sex scene, but it has nothing to do with anybody degrading anybody. I mean, power dynamics are very normal in real life in the bedroom. I think we all know that, but that's something that we all kind of have within us. We have we have this need to sort of play with power dynamics in our sex lives, to some extent or another. Not everybody goes as far as what you see in some porn movies, but that it's a totally normal thing that shouldn't be vilified. What I came out and said was that I don't consider myself a feminist pornographer, because I'm not, I don't consider the movies that I make are available. I'm looking at everything through the, you know, my eyes as a woman. I'm a female perspective, you know, any more than if I were a lawyer, that I would be a feminist lawyer because I'm a woman and I'm, you know, I'm approaching my work as a woman. I'm approaching my work as somebody that wants to depict something real and honest and authentic. And that was the issue that I had with it. And that sort of caused a lot. I wrote a blog about it for the Huffington Post, and it caused a lot of, anger, you could say. And it was perceived as my not being supportive of the feminist porn community or grateful for the awards that I was receiving from the Feminist Porn Awards. And there was a lot of clarification made that feminist porn actually is meant to describe, you know, any kind of ethical porn. Including, you know, male filmmakers, or that this term was supposed to encompass everybody. But I didn't think that was true because I started making gay movies, and my gay movies were not included at the Feminist Porn Awards. It was still very much focused on women. You know, as much as I love the Feminist Porn Award people, I think they're some of the most amazing people I've ever met, the ladies that run Good for Her and run the awards. But I do like to keep the politics kind of out of it, and I don't think that it's necessary. And I think it's a little bit disingenuous, this idea that women came into porn and suddenly became this very beautiful sort of, you know, wonderful thing, whereas before, when men were in charge, it was disgusting. You know, that's not my impression from talking to fans and from listening to men talk about what they want to see.
A simple plan for life is change. Find yourself the nicest strange. Can you see the light? Can you find the right lane on a bright lane?